In this video, we're going to create a billboard in Jab Editor. This particular billboard is going to use grommets and tile panels, which will be used to create a full file. I'm going to start by opening my file into Jab Editor. The next step is to turn on my tiling setup. So I'm going to go to my Tiling Setup tab and enable tiling. This particular file needs to be resized, so I'm going to click on the Preview and Size tab and change my size choice to 300%. Now you can see the tile panels appear based on my maximum printing width for my roll size. I want to make these tile panels equal size spacing, so I'm going to go back into my tiling setup and I'm going to change each of these columns to be the same equal even amount. So if I take my overall size and divide that out by 3, I'd get my dimensions, and now I can change this to match for each of the 3 columns. Now I can see my column choices are the same dimensions, and I have my tile panel set. I'm also going to set an overlap of a half of an inch. This half inch amount is going to split on both sides of each tile panel. Repeating the image information, it's going to allow this for easy lineup when I'm putting these files together. The next step I need to perform is to enable my bleed. I'm going to click on my Finishing tab and enable the image bleed, and I'm going to set my bleed amount for 4 inches overall. You'll notice my bleed type choices can be color or mirrored image or duplication, where it will just repeat that last pixel on the end of the file overall. I'm going to leave this set to mirror. I'm also going to enable my frame corner marks. And now I can set my grommets. I'm going to click on my grommets tab and I'm going to enable my grommets for the top, bottom, left, and right. Here I can control spacing or quantity, and I'm going to set my spacing so that I get a grommet mark every 6 inches. Furthermore, I'm going to place these grommets in the bleed area. I have a selection of different styles as well as my mark information to be a solid line or a dotted line in either black or white, and I can control the thickness, or I can do an alternative line where it'll be a black, white repeat, and I can control my thickness here as well. Once I make my mark style and option choices, next I'm going to set my offset. So I can control from the top, bottom, left, and right starting position of where these grommets should be from the edge. So I'm going to set this number to 2 inches. And you'll notice from the very edge I've got 2 inches over as my starting point for my top and my bottom and for the left and the right sides. Now I'm going to go on to my marks and enable my registration mark setting. Keep in mind all of the conditions that we see, all of the settings that we can choose, are case by case, and the job dictates the different needs and the different settings for this. We have a variety of different options that we can select here. It just depends on what your needs are. Once I have performed these steps, I look at my work and I see that this could make a very nice preset as a quick set. So at this point, I'm going to export out these particular parameters as a quick set. In this screen, I can select any additional quick set options. Otherwise, I can save, and I will name the file appropriately to identify the type of work that this quick set will perform. Now that I have these quick set parameters exported out, back in my rip queue, I could import that and use that billboard quick set time and time again. As it stands right now, this job is completed. I'm going to submit this to my rip. Now I can see my completed job. And if I look over to the right in my print preview, I will see my 3 tile panels. I'd like to point out an additional option we have in our placement strategy. where we can flip every other tile. In doing so, our tile panels will flip as every other tile. So if you have a need to do this, you can enable that feature set or disable that as you like. Now at this point, I can print this file and print my tile panels. Let's visit the exported QuickSet. In order to import that, I need to get into my QuickSets menu. So I will click on Configure Printer. You'll notice my first tab is my QuickSets, and this is where I could import my exported QuickSet for the billboard. This QuickSet of the billboard will contain the tile panel settings, my bleed, my grommet, and all of my other mark information, essentially everything I've set within my job editor. When I want to use this within a job, all I have to do is bring the job in and select that particular QuickSet. No need to go to job editor and make these changes manually, as this QuickSet for billboard will apply those effects automatically. Now I see it's very easy to apply my QuickSet to accomplish the billboard settings. It keeps me consistent, it keeps me repeatable, and it saves me time from doing this manually. And there I have my billboard QuickSet created, as well as my files applied with those feature sets.